The Guitar, a poem by Federico García Lorca. The lament of the guitar begins. The wine cups of daybreak are broken. The lament of the guitar begins. It is useless to silence it. It is impossible to silence it. It weeps, monotonous, as the water weeps, as the wind weeps over the snowfall. It is impossible to silence it. It weeps for things far away, sands of the warm south, asking for white camellias. It weeps arrow without target, evening without morning, and the first dead bird upon the branch. Oh, guitar, heart grievously wounded by five swords. Fifth movement, Rhapsody, Granados and Nationalism.
When at the end of the 19th century, after the Spanish-American War, and when Spain, in fact, had lost the last vestige of its empire, Spain began to look inward, and it had to redefine its political and cultural institutions. Now, there's a very remarkable man that lived in the 19th century, was born 1841, and his name was Felipe Pedrel. And even before the fall of Puerto Rico, which was the last part of the empire to fall, Felipe Pedrel was already traveling around Spain collecting folk songs from gypsies in bars, and in fact, all over Spain in many different areas of social life. He searched through museums and church libraries and found and rediscovered, rather, a whole wealth of remarkable Renaissance church music by Morales and Victoria and others. And he published these. And it was this extraordinary combination of this early, highly disciplined contrapuntal church music and the folk songs that gave the inspiration for many of the composers that were to come.
Spanish Dance No. 5 by Enrique Granados, transcribed for the guitar. Granados, born in 1867, began his musical studies here in Barcelona. Then, as now, it was the major city of northern Spain, a vast urban area populated more densely than any other place in Europe. Barcelona has for more than 100 years combined the new industries of Spain with the commerce of an ancient port. Industrial labor was imported from the south, from Andalusia, and with it came anarchism, syndicalism, every kind of radical political activity. A middle class made prosperous by industrial growth became the patrons of a renewed artistic activity. Dedicatoria by Granados. Artists seeking a new national expression often look to the past for their inspiration. And the past for Granados meant above all the period and the work of Goya. La Maja de Goya by Granados. On the skyline of Barcelona, the writhing forms of Gaudi's architecture stand as witnesses to the bizarre vigor of Catalan culture at the turn of the century. They may seem heady monuments to the fashion for Art Nouveau, but they were part of a search for a new artistic identity. Typical of the period is La Paloma, a dance hall straight out of the 1890s. Valses Poéticos by Granados.
one of the very interesting facets of this nationalism that emerged towards the end of the 19th century was a reawakening of interest in the very antiquity of Spain, which somehow united Spain. Pedrell, Granados, Albanus were all from the north. In fact, they were Catalan. But suddenly, these northerners saw the immense richness of this country, particularly in the south.
Spanish Dance Number 4, Villanesca, by Granados. Sixth movement, Evocation, Isaac Albéniz.
We're here in Camperdon, a little town tucked up high in the Pyrenees, probably as far north as you can get in Spain. In fact, the border is just a few kilometers over the hill there. It's a delightful little town and very important to me personally, because it's the birthplace of perhaps the greatest Spanish musician of the 19th century, Isaac Albéniz. Albéniz, I suppose, being born here, was a musician of Catalan sensibilities, if you like, even French. But his heart was in the south, and it was in Andalusia that he traveled a great deal and wrote much of his finest music. But I've lost my music case. I've lost my music.
No, right. Carlos?
Cadiz by Albéniz, transcribed for the guitar.
Albéniz eventually returned to Barcelona to find a patron who paid his fare and other expenses to go to Leipzig in Germany and study the piano. And no less a master did he have than Franz Liszt. His piano playing must have been astounding even at this age, because to have been a pupil of Liszt, you would have had to have gone through several layers of musical KGB to get to the great master. After Albanus had finished his studies, he began his very successful career as a concert pianist. From time to time, he came back to Spain. His habit in those days was to take a train trip. This time, of course, he could pay for the ticket. Down to the south, stay in a town for a few days, write a piece of music, then move off to the next town. Some of his finest compositions are little tome poems on the great cities of the south.
Granada by Albéniz.
seasick.
What does she want? She wants another drink.
Yeah.
Una cerveza.
Otra cerveza quiero.
Sí.
Pero vamos.
Chincho.
Sevilla, by Albéniz. A poem by Federico García Lorca. Long live Sevilla. The women in Sevilla carry on their mantillas a notice which says, Long live Sevilla.
Albana's music, with the exception of three operas that he wrote, amazingly so, in English, and one orchestral piece and one piece for piano and orchestra. All the other works were written for the solo pianoforte. But because the guitar is such a suggestive instrument, to my mind, it's as though one is orchestrating or reorchestrating these pieces on the guitar. And with our modern approach to interpretation, and indeed with all the developments of modern guitar technique that we now have at our disposal, we can reinterpret this music in a way which gives it a vividness and a life which I'm sure Albanians would now adore.
Córdoba by Albéniz. Thank you. Seventh movement, Homage, the guitar in the 20th century. The Guitar Speaks by Manuel Machado. I speak, I cry, I am delirious. I know about laughter and lamentation. With red mouths I sing, with black eyes I see. With lovers I sigh and laugh with jokers. My trickling notes are like fresh water in a rose garden. I have all the salt of Spain in my tears. The first movement of the Sonatina by Toroba. Composed in the 1920s, it was the first extended piece written for the guitar in more than 100 years. It's dedicated to the master of all 20th century guitarists, Andrés Segovia. A guitar factory near Valencia. The guitar has always been the most democratic of instruments. It's played on a street corner, in a cafe, or in a concert hall. Part of Spain's essential culture, it's now also part of the country's industry. The city of Granada.
Manu de Falla must be the greatest composer that Spain has ever produced. He lived for many years in this charming but quite austere little house. And it was here that he wrote his only guitar piece, an elegy in memory of Debussy, which he calls Homenaje, pull a Tombeau de Debussy. It's a remarkable piece, not only because Fayot was the first composer to write for the instrument without actually being able to play it, but it is, in the guitar repertoire, one of the most important and most beautiful, and certainly one of the most outstanding pieces written for the instrument. And it actually brought the guitar into the 20th century.
Homage for the Tomb of Debussy by Manuel de Falla.
Another thing about Fayot that was that he, in my estimation, was the most truly Spanish composer. Albéniz and Granados certainly wrote some stunning music. And they used the folklore in a way that gave them an impetus for their inspiration. But they never or rarely used folklore for its own sake. But Fayot was quite different. He, after all, was an Andalusian. He was born in Cadiz. He lived here in Granada. And therefore the sound of the gypsy music, the flamenco, must have often been in his ears. And in fact, the flamenco style, the cante hondo, is evident in very many of his compositions.
The Miller's Dance from De Falla's ballet, The Three-Cornered Hat. Guitar of the Inn by Antonio Machado. Guitar of the Inn, today you play a jota, tomorrow a petanera, depending on whoever arrives and plucks the dusty string. Guitar of the roadside inn, you were never nor ever will be a poet. You are a spirit which speaks its lonely harmony to passing spirits. And always when the traveler hears you, he dreams he hears an air from his native land. Thank you. Valencia, the festival of the fires of St. John. Federico García Lorca once wrote that Spain was a country open to death. Throughout the country, everything finds its final metallic value in death. Spain is the only country where death is the national spectacle. A dead man in Spain is more alive as a dead man than in any other place in the world. From The Six Strings, a poem by Lorca. The guitar makes dreams weep. The lament of lost souls escapes through its round mouth. Tiento by Maurice Ohana. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.